Today, we will explore a man who has lived through the more difficult side of this era. He is the one and only Marc Chagall, a brilliant pioneer in the field of painting. Chagall was born on July 7, 1887 in Vitebsk, Belarus, a small province that neighbors Russia. He grew up peacefully as a child and felt comfortable in the quiet environment he was in. But as he grew older, his eyes began to open to the tragedies that were happening around him. He lived through the Russian Revolution, World War I, the Great Depression, and many other extreme and often tragic events. Chagall's paintings are presented as a witness account of the turbulent 20th century. One aspect of these hard times that especially affected Chagall was the oppression of Judaism and the ethnic Jews who lived in Europe. Chagall himself was Jewish and had personally experienced the hardships in his life that many others were forced to endure. With the outbreak of World War II, Chagall was forced to flee France, in which he had settled into years earlier. Chagall was barely able to escape Hitler's expanding anti-Semitic empire. Besides this, he, like many others, had to deal with the lack of equal rights, poor treatment, and additional burdens that were put forth due to his faith and ethnicity. He spilled these issues onto the canvas metaphorically. In Paris Through the Window, oppression of the Jews is clearly seen in multiple instances. A peculiar man is located in the bottom right-hand corner of the painting, who, oddly enough, appears to have two different faces. The naturally colored profile that is facing backwards represents his true self, showing that he literally had to put it behind him. Instead, he sports the artificially colored blue face that symbolizes a defeated and oppressed man, unwillingly living with the definition that society has created for him. Another example of Jewish oppression can also be seen in this work. Focus your attention to the two figures floating horizontally in the background of the painting. The couple can be identified as Jewish given the man's clothing, traditional rabbi attire. Like the man's face on the bottom right, these two figures can be seen conforming to the unnatural and unfair rules they are forced to adhere to in their specific environment. To Chagall, these oppressing factors that targeted him separated him from a large part of humanity. Jews were considered inferior and different, which in turn created an enormous sense of isolation and disconnectedness. This dramatically lonely atmosphere is seen throughout many of his pieces. In his artwork entitled War, a Jewish man stands alone in the dark while a lively group of soldiers march behind him, completely unaware of his troubled existence. He is utterly alienated from everything and everyone. The shadow that covers his face blankets his true emotions, another example of how the Jews are cast out of the norm and dehumanized. Once more, isolation can be seen through a series of pieces Chagall painted that depicted the Jews in exile, constantly fleeing from the dangers that keep catching up to them. These works give off a heavy air of desperation and fatigue. When one is constantly in motion, there is no true place to call home, no sense of belonging whatsoever. The metaphor of the walking house, or walking village, is constantly used to demonstrate such conditions. Here, Chagall personifies a group of homes by literally giving them a pair of human legs. So where does one turn to escape the suffering? What gives life its purpose and what cushions all of these hardships? To Chagall, the simple answer was love. He saw the incredible universal healing power of this unseen force, which extended far beyond the tragedy of Jewish suffering. It is an entity that can mend any such wound on anyone. It sees no boundaries. In Chagall's Woman with Blue Face, a man and a woman are wrapped in a warm embrace amidst a dark and chaotic environment. The white force field that envelops them symbolizes love. Chagall shows us that no matter how deranged or demented our lives may be, if we have someone or something that is there for us, inner peace can be found.